Hey, it's Skeery Jones, and we're back with another episode of CEO Unplugged. Today, we have Jon Stein here from Betterment. I love that.
Yeah,
that's great. That, even just the word Betterment makes me want to be a better person, right?
It means make things better. I mean, that's what,
right.
It's like this old-fashioned word that nobody uses anymore. But.
No, it's fascinating. Yeah. So tell us a little bit, first of all, about Betterment. What are you trying to make better in people's lives?
We help people do what's best for their money so they can live better. Betterment is an online financial manager. We take all the stuff that a great financial advisor would do for you if you had one, and we make it smarter, faster, cheaper, better, and accessible to anybody.
Isn't that a Kanye West song? Smarter, faster, cheaper, better?
Sounds like one.
Oh,
yeah.
No. So really, I wanted to know real quick, because I get goosebumps when I hear the word financial planning. You know, all of a sudden these visions of this grueling process enter my head. So take us through somebody who's scared of the process and how you guys are different from that.
It's absolutely intimidating. Nobody likes to think about their money. You know, nobody likes to deal with it. It's like doing your taxes. Who looks forward to that?
I just want to think about spending it, and that's about it.
That's the fun part.
Right.
But, I was the same. I was exactly the same as you. I was intimidated by it. I thought, God, this is so much work. Why is it so hard to do the right thing? And I was working in the industry, right? So I was working consulting to some of the country's largest banks and investment firms and seeing how they work on the inside and seeing very often that they weren't doing what's best for the customer. They were doing whatever made them the most money, not what made the customer the most money. And I thought there's got to be a better way to do this, to put power in the hands of the customers, to build a product around the customer that helps them do the right thing. And it's got to be easy, because finance is so intimidating, because it can be so awful. So we made Betterment really easy to get you to the right answer for you.
So you launched it in 2008. Is that true? But it went to the public in 2010. So you kind of... you know, tinkered with it in the background, and then you said, oh, this is ready for prime time, and it was ready in about 9 years ago now.
Well, it takes an insane amount of time and effort to build a regulated financial advisor and a broker-dealer. Like, you know, we're regulated by the SEC and FINRA. There's a lot that goes on to launch a company like this. So, well, I did start it in my apartment, you know, on the Lower East Side, and we got going with a few people. It took years to put it together and to get all of our clearances and approvals.
How did you turn it from something you started in your apartment to managing $16 billion in assets, more than that, just 9 years later?
Well, when I started, I very foolishly thought I was just going to do everything on my own. My first business plan.
You took
was
the
like,
whole world on your shoulders.
Yeah.
So I
thought, okay, I'll just learn to code, and I taught myself to code. I'll just learn the law, and I bought all these legal books and started figuring out how we'd be regulated and so on. And over time, I was talking to enough friends about this, and they said, hey, I think I could help you with that. You know, like I can stand up a site for you. My roommate at the time was an engineer at Google, which was lucky. I've been lucky a lot in all of this. And one of my friends was a securities lawyer, and he said, I can help you with this. And I said, great, because I don't want all these legal books anymore. You take them.
So you surrounded yourself with great people from the start.
Exactly. Despite my own naivety, like people were coming and saying, hey, I can help you with that. And I started giving things away and giving them work to do. And over time, we built a really amazing team, and that's how we got to where we are today, was hiring great people.
Now, at one point, you worked on Wall Street. Now, what was your takeaway from actually being in the trenches? Were you like on the stock floor? Like, where were you on Wall Street? What did you do?
I was consulting to banks. So I was I was having fun. I wasn't on the Wall Street floor. I had a client in Puerto Rico, in San Juan. I had clients in Australia.
I always think trading floor. I think like that running around, high blood pressure.
Yeah.
I think of, Wolf of Wall Street. I think of Leonardo DiCaprio.
Exactly.
But so what did you take away from that?
I mean, I was on some trading floors, but that maybe they were in Chicago or Akron.
Right.
Or,
okay.
So all over the place. I had clients, and I saw, very often I was just doing product development work, say for some clients, and I'd be on a 6-month engagement, and we would look at all the bank's internal numbers. What are the default rates? What's the transfer rate to price this thing? But we would never talk to a customer as we were designing a product. And I thought there's just not enough innovation in financial services.
Oh.
There's not enough creativity around what customers really need. So in Australia, for instance, they have this cool product. It's called a mortgage offset. And you can deposit and take your mortgage out of the same account. So if you overpay your mortgage, it's in a deposit account earning interest for you instead of, you know, you're not paying interest on that. We don't have that here. And I thought, hey, you know, like, we could really do a lot more innovation to make products better for people.
Wow. So you took another country's concept and you applied it here.
Well, I didn't take exactly that one because I realized that the biggest need here was for people to start investing and invest in the right way.
So we invest poorly?
We invest terribly.
As a country?
Yeah, because the investing system that we have wasn't designed for you and me. It was designed for these big institutional investors to trade with each other. And then in the 80s, the 401k came along and the IRA came along and Social Security was no longer fully funded. And since then, now everyone has defined contribution plans, meaning you know how much you're putting in, mm-hmm. and you don't know how much you're going to get out at the other end. We came from an era of defined benefit where we had pensions and
right.
everyone knew exactly what they were going to have in retirement.
Yeah.
But now almost everyone who's listening is responsible for their own retirement. And yet we haven't given them the tools to save intelligently, to do the right thing, and to make sure that they're on track to a good retirement.
So that's what Betterment does.
That's what Betterment does.
Walk us through the process of signing up. Let's say I have nothing backing me. I don't know anything about any finances whatsoever except getting my taxes done every year. How do I get started with Betterment? What's required? What are the fees? Like what, you know, and how do I know that I'm in good hands? Just walk us through the process.
Yeah. So for those who are scared, the first things to know is there's no minimum balance. It's really easy. You can get started. You can do it all online. You can call us if you have any questions.
And it walks you through the process 1, 2, 3. Like there's not going to be a point where I'm going to get stumbled on. I'm going to stumble over something on the website. Like maybe I'll get back to this later because I don't.
Well, if you do, you can call us up. You can email us. Right. We've got live customer support 7 days a week.
But so fairly easy to digest in the enrollment process.
Most customers never call us. Right.
So, oh wow. Okay.
Yeah, because it's just that easy. And it's also because most customers never have to call us mm-hmm. and we don't have a bunch of branches out there that we have to support, it's really cheap.
Yeah.
So we charge 0.25%. That's our only fee that we ever charge.
Okay.
Whereas like the average, you know, broker is charging you for transactions, the average investment advisor might be charging a lot more. Mm. Now they might be doing other things for you. They might be asking you to come in and sit down and do an estate plan. But for a lot of our customers, they don't need all of that. They're just looking to get started investing. And make some smart decisions with your money.
I could tell just by the way you're talking to me about this, about the product, about everything, that this is like you live this, you live it, you breathe it. This isn't just a job for you.
Do I use too much jargon? Is that
no, it's great. What makes you most excited about it?
I do this because I feel like I've been very lucky in my life. And I went to school and studied economics as an undergrad. I went to business school. I learned a lot about investing at Columbia Business School. I got a CFA, which is I'm a chartered financial analyst, so mm-hmm. I know all about it. I should know all about investing, right? Like if anybody should know. And yet I went out and I opened, you know, 7 different brokerage accounts in my young years, and all of them were too complicated. All of them tried to get me to do the thing that was right for them, not the thing that was right for me.
Right.
And I thought, if this is this complicated for somebody who knows really like as much as one can know about investing and is doing this, you know, professionally, imagine what it's like for somebody who doesn't have all these advantages.
Sure.
And I just really wanted to make it easy for everyone to do the right thing with their money. I was motivated in college by economics and behavioral biology, because the thing that behavior, you know, if you study human behavior, mm-hmm. we make mistakes all the time. We're always getting in our own way. We're so like,
we're our own worst enemy. If you think about it, would you say sometimes?
Absolutely.
When it comes to hiring for the company, what kinds of things do you look for in a candidate?
I always look for 3 things, and candidates ask me this in the interview, and I always say the same thing. I'm looking for horsepower, passion, and openness. Horsepower. I just want people who are generally smart, who are flexible, who are intellectually curious, who can just get things done. You know, passion. You don't have to be passionate about personal finance. You don't have to be passionate about anything in particular, but you got to be passionate about something because that makes you interesting to work with.
Sure.
And open. You got to ask good questions. You got to listen well. You got to be this attitude.
How am I doing right now in the listening department?
I'm doing great. Okay. Yeah. I'm enjoying this. I'm probably doing less well.
No, you're doing great.
You got to understand that when two people disagree, mm-hmm. it's not because one is right and the other is wrong. It's because you're probably operating from different fact bases. And if you can just talk, Wow. You can increase the overlap.
We should apply this in everyday society. We would be fighting less with each other, right? What's next for Betterment? What do you guys see? What's coming up in the next couple of years? Where do you see your company going?
So I'm really excited about a couple of things. On the one hand, we've mastered personal investing. We're working really well. We've got 400,000 customers, right? Growing fast, managing $16 billion. We're expanding into the 401k, and that's an exciting area. We've been growing that 401k business, mm-hmm. which is, you know, the plan you sure. get at your employer. That's been growing really well for us. The other thing that I'm excited about is when we look at all the things that we could do for our customers and we rank them, we force rank, you know, what matters? Diversification matters. Low-cost investments matters. Tax management. All of this stuff matters. But, you know, the number one thing on that list is how much are you saving? If I can get you to save 2-4% more per year out of your paycheck, that has a tremendous impact on your long-term financial health. More than like you paid an extra, you know, $25 fees here. What more important than anything else? Mm-hmm. And so I'm really excited about cash management and how we help people save better. That's our big project for 2019.
Now, when it comes to the online competition for online financial planning, like you have mm-hmm. other companies out there that do this, what does Betterment do better? What does Betterment do better?
I think of our core advantage is convenience. We make it so easy to do the smart thing with your money, yeah. right? Can you go and can you figure out all the tax loss harvesting that we do and the asset location that we do? Sure, if you study a bunch, you take a bunch of courses, you spend, you know, 10 hours a day managing your money, you can do all of this stuff. But we have algorithms that are just automatically helping you do the right thing, putting you in control without spending all of that time.
Then that's probably why you should allow people to trust you with their money, right? I mean, because it's a lot, you know, it's a big, you know, a lot of people will be like, okay, am I getting into the right thing? Is this going to disappear on me? There's a lot of people's trust in your hands.
One reason people trust us is that we're tech enabled, right? We're a tech company and technology doesn't lie. It doesn't give a different answer to a different person on a different day, right?
It's and consistent. The algorithms don't lie that you have consistent. In place. Right? So those are the fail safes.
So you're not having to like trust that this person, you know, woke up well and is giving you fair advice and doesn't have some sort of like, you know, other interest in making. We don't sell anything. We don't sell any of our own products, right? We don't manufacture our own exchange-traded funds or mutual funds. And we don't manufacture our own insurance. We don't have our own.
You have no vested interest.
No vested interest in it. So we're choosing the right products for you. And yep. we get no financial gain from recommending those things. The only way we make money is that fee that you pay us, that 25 basis right. points or 0.25%.
So you guys
and that means we're aligned with our customers.
So you're super neutral in this. You're exactly. not selling other products. You're not trying to sway people in a direction.
And that makes us unique from all the incumbents, all the big firms, all the brand names that you know.
Oh, they all have skin in the game.
Exactly.
You guys don't.
That's right. That makes us different.
Wow. Quite honestly, I learned a lot in this last 10 minutes or so. Yeah. I mean, because I'm trying to go through my head. I'm like, who is being a snake oil salesman with my money right now? And you know what I'm saying? Because it's true. A lot of people, and that's one of the, that's such an important driving point. It's like, you guys are a neutral engine that's there. Everything's based on algorithms and, you know, math pretty much.
Yeah. You know, it's been a long journey, right? And when we first started, you know, Chris Sacca said on stage at TechCrunch Disrupt, you know, this is too simple. People want finance to be complicated. This will never
do
work.
They?
Yeah, right?
Like, yeah, oh, really?
That's what he said, because that's the way it was. And
how many years ago going
said,
back?
Is and ought. Just because the way, just because something is a way doesn't mean it should be that
yep.
way. And so just because it was complicated doesn't mean that's the right way for it to be. So we've made it easy. Mm-hmm. And people might ask questions. And you might ask, well, that's great, John. Like, you know, this company Betterment, you know, 400,000 customers, why not tens of millions? What if it's so great, why isn't everybody doing that? And I'd say that's because of inertia, right? Like, people are doing the thing they've been doing and they like to keep doing that thing.
Creatures of habit.
It's a hassle yeah. to do anything different. Wow. And so we're just trying our best to help people overcome that inertia by making it easy. That's it.
That's awesome. Well, like, lots of luck and continued success with Betterment.
Thank you.
Jon Stein right here from CEO Unplugged. Yeah. We have a CEO, but we actually are plugged in because we have a microphone. But
at least we're not wearing, you know.
No, that's true. That's
we
true.
We can get up and walk around if we want.
Well, thanks so much, man.
Yeah, thank
Pleasure.
You so much.
Thanks for stopping by.